Well, first I'd like to thank you about the opportunity of presenting my research and this artist's work that brought to my view many concepts I have read on Deleuze's and Guattari's work. My studies took place in Brazil and were held by the Universidade Federal of Rio Grande do Sul. Currently, I teach at the dramatic course of the Universidade Federal of Pelotas, located on the same state. However, the principal information about my background, what I'm going to provide here in this presentation, is about what I not have worked in my life, such as performing in dance or in theater. So that, as a performer, I use it to accept as true that the theater resides on performance value and its apprehension over spatial, textual, and lighting concepts. Sure, it is true to say that the theater is the actor is the center of this expression, which are some arts. But I ignored that the stage could also be a place of some manual and sensible expression, such as a square or a paper for painting or drawing or even a music instrument, or a stone for those who make music or sculptures. The stage as support through its visually and spatial arrangements. It was through Zoë de Grandes creations I could realize operations such as a parting bond and flash, giving machines to athleticism, the manual and sensorial put together, the coupling as essence, a really pluralized way of playing signs, which are at the same time objective ones and for the ciphering, requiring forces because erased from generative forces. This Brazilian fine artist holds a plural which brings to surface in a peculiar acting of living and recreation things continuously the sensation as described on the Deleuze and Guattari's tests. And the Gunny developed her creations largely unaware about the Gunny, Deleuze's and Guattari's work. It was up to me to make the link between practice and theory. Let me show you then how her work presents variation intrinsically related to its expression. Before arriving to the theater, her overread was theatrical, with it understood as an ephemeral quality shared with the audience, while this audience is not just there to passively see an artistic work, but to be witnesses of this work, which has a changing process under their view. The fact is that as a researcher, I could find, reviewing some of her most important works, what a Brazilian author, Salles, calls the artist's great project. So I detached 19 years of her career to analysis, starting on 1993 and ending on 2012. By the impossibility of reviewing the whole works she had realized between this period, I focused on a sample of them. Thinking over the Gunny's great project, I could find a theatrical quality that escapes from its specificity. It were crossing her work even on galleries or museums while she still operated in fine arts. And what I call theatrical quality refers by a side for a necessarily coupling to bodies. Even thought to exhibition, her work already had these characteristics. And further, her work is used to brought to view, or better saying to sensation, the undeniable passage of time. For instance, on the work There Is No Guilt, on the apple seed or the yoke, the first had as protagonist 12 apples supported by 12 metal pieces. And it's worth saying these metal pieces were kitchen utensils manipulated by the artists in their shape, but preserving their main aspect, so part recognizable and part being other thing. Well, so There Is No Guilt in the apple seeds obviously brings a clear reference to Brazilian religious culture, the Catholic heritage. But it was not it the main subject of the work, but apples growing processes. Therefore, to the time it was exposed, it was possible to see how the red and yellow fruit decays until turn itself into a single seed again. In this sense, it is possible to link to what Deleuze says about bringing to surface the sensation. It does not happen inside or deeply, but in the surface, the time passing through apples bodies make us feel it passing through our bodies. This artistic work, by its time, has visual signs as its main structure. Well, so the main sign of this work was to be deciphered, but we can find also evidence of a mathematical game. While there were 12 metal pieces supporting 12 apples, a clear reference to 12 months of the year, but also to 12 apostles, or even to 12 houses of astrological charts, and maybe other relations are possible. While this search for reference can be easily deniable, as the evidence of the work is stronger than any hidden meaning, there is anything hidden. But the evidence of variation exposed, requiring perception from perception, the material of the earth. The material is the time passing. The life cycle was turned into an aesthetic signature, revolving through simplistic or complex life adventure. Similar to this happened on the world of the young. This one also concerned to make visible the invisible time passing, built from tons of plants that work regarding all the process of life and death. From the yellow seed, which turned into green, and then to death, when it gave places to other forms of life. Bodies invaded these both works. Despite the fact they have been taught to galleries, the first one had already a shared action program in the opening and in the ending of the work, where apples, not the exposed ones, were given to the audience, who were invited to eat those apples and give back to the artist the seeds. In the end, the audience received back the seeds from the apple they have eaten, being clearly part of the process of life that will rebirth, impelled to taking part in it. But a dance performance, it was not previously planned, and it was just what happened when a local choreographer met them. She felt it was stronger than the polite feelings of not invading others' work. She felt that she must dance on it, she must perform with the installation art. Once the work is exposed, it will not belong to the artist anymore, but to people in front of it. And if the people feel attracted for the opus, they keep resigning it. The opus is free, it is exposed to variation. So there is no guilt in the apple seed was placed to a dancing performance. The yolk, by other side, was invaded for the public that used it to lay down over the yolk when it was in the first stage, a huge yellow yolk made from grains. But nothing can be compared to what happened on the salt room. To start, salt room was named by the public. The original name of this word was immortalizing the memory. But the other, which were given by population, got stronger. Visitors, in an ever-same attitude in Brazil, elaborated by their own, I mean, there was not an instruction to visit the work. It was just an installation piece of art in a very busy local on the sea to the public market, but they elaborated kind of a ritual to visit it when they took out their shoes and walked through the work. A petition was organized by population to ask for the work to be permanently in the city. They didn't reach this, but they could extend the exhibition for about 2 weeks. This is just to emphasize the characters of this work that easily leave the artist, despite the fact that her signature is still there. But the Gurney's authorial concerns part specifically to its quality of composing an oak that escapes from its origins as well reinforces its destination, marking at the same time its rhizomatic consequences, leaving the creator is given to its own variation possibilities. I would like to show you then the piano as well, all made from rice and beans. These 4 works I have just provided here belong to the period I called Pre-Lucene. As we can see, performers and the public are already crossing their works in galleries or museums. And it is quite, it's not so precisely to distinguish a pre-Lucenic, a scenic, or a post-scenic work, because the Gurney holds a plural. Her work is never just in one field, but commonly spreads freely, invading more than one language or more than one expression. As we have just seen, it was an installation art that fits to performance or to a public content ritual, or even to a whole spectacle, as it happens in the work The Bath. The Bath was a series of installations that took place in many cities in Brazil and having each one made from the same objects, but placed in different forms, depending on the room it was set in. It was born from a profound investigation about the end of the potable water decline, subject that the Gurney worked over since the 80s, as well as other ecological trends. The Bath and the House was one of them. It is needed to say that all the works never had even one drop of water. Therefore, the series that started in 1997 developed to a deeply desire of having dancing on it. In 2001, the Gurney brought to her work, added with a dance company, and also a video art. It was a plural spectacle. The artist spent 1 year rebuilding an old hardware warehouse, which was completely abandoned, dirty, and covered by a black layer of grease, from where she made a huge white and clean space. So the bath is a spectacle that brings to me many aspects of variation and intensity. The coupling of bodies and objects requiring an athleticism, a physical one, instead of the representation, the objects on scene are disposed to a real requirement from performance, an attitude, an acting by the real meaning of the word, when action emerges from relation. Especially as a Rad announcer for her installations, the relations are pluralized. It is a work that emerges from space, from a profound sense of visual impression, but it spreads, connects, and rearranges all other elements disposed in the stage. Let me show you some examples. There was a gigantic wave that danced with performers, putting bodies at risk, but was also the representation of the dry tubes from a civilization without water. The object at the same time sustains a representation role and the evidence of what it is in fact. Its presence is more powerful than its apparent meaning. As you can see in the image, the next one, besides dancing with performers, the tube also crosses the stage by itself. Therefore, a single piece brings its truly functional uses, preserves its real role in the world, but is enhanced by its relational consequences. The scrap is now a piece of set design in service of sensation, reverting the useless object now dancing alone or together to performers. It cross-witnesses feelings, perceptions, affects, who are sharing a real drying sensation. Spectators or witnesses set on tones of coarse salt, experiencing dryness feeling. The lack of water was real through spatial sensations, not the representation of an illusion. As she uses to do, the glen sets pieces to require performances. They are not in the stage to represent anything, but really to realize an effort that will save them a form of interpreting. The risk is real as well with play poetry by the encounter of the contrast with the object. Sometimes it is inserting some prostheses, as in Baby's Family, the operation of crossing performance by. The same object is there to deal with. Set designs acts, require actions, and can, by their consequences, create a block of present sensations. The petrified waterfall were all built from old tubes and composing of culture and plaster was one of the landscapes in Babel. And a video art was exhibited as part of the work called Which Song Will You Sing in Your Last Bath? Part documentary and part images collected of water remembering. A coupling of languages that to broadly corroborate the sensation. All these expressions put together, reiterating each other in different ways, makes intensity cross scenes. The lesson, a more recent work dated 2010, was raised from a very different spatial quality than the bath. Placed at an arena, it was also from spatial forces through visual signs over its impossibilities as in space that she makes emerge possibilities of pluralizing sensations. For the drama from Eugène Ionescu, which holds as subject the oppression from a professor over a pupil, it was the knowledge as powder for subjugating the pupil and the sensation of being oppressed which impregnates over walls and structures this time. But the main object, doubtless, is the chair where the drama ends. Since an old chair from schools, very common on most of the classes in Brazil, she built a torture chair. This object conducted to one of the 10 most impacting scenes during the year on Semic Arts, noted by the critics. The powder of crossing sensation of this object resides on the fact that it has its structure replaced. The part that holds notebooks and pens now are duplicated and put under the structure, on where students' legs were held. Pieces were put to hold neck and arms. But another instance has also a great impact over witnesses. The sound made from iron bars that remains at the same time a swing by the sound of metal pieces brushing when a child goes backwards and forwards, as well as a dilacerating sound. It could fit perfectly both at the same time, bringing the childhood and annihilating the same piece. Besides that, under the chair was a basin where, after Popo's murder, still drips blood constantly, and the remaining drip in the city. So that the same object crosses the soundtrack, the performer's actions, the audience sensations, while has in it all the references from the school chair, a torture chair, and a struggling relationship. But further, the operational response to saturation of every atom that goes further than reference is evidence, is condensation and dissipation. Some details from the set design show the mutilated dolls wrapped in bandages, having heads studded with screws, the blackboard on which the professor uses to write the lesson almost in the end turns and reveals many heads inside its surface. Some angles of the space for the lesson, we can note the columns, next one, dressed in metal courses, when the space also converts to an oppressive sensation. Even columns are reddened, no one can breathe, even the space, even the columns are turned into a body without organs, the intensity runs over spatial arrangement. Talking about bases and dolls, I cannot finish without presenting this kind of cast that goes along with the career of the girls. It is quite a personal alphabet if we think it since emerging a particular language. If in fine arts it was seeds of ephemeral materials she dealt with, but also bases already, which are urban shells for the gunny who grew up on a beach. This object is found all over her trajectory. In scenic arts, there are red graphs, keys, dolls, chairs, flowers, bandages, chains, among other regular elements, thought as a personal casting of piece. It will appear in many spectacles, serving different scenes and situations, marking a signature that is marked by possibilities of variations. Body's basings, each picture brings a different work, and of course there are others I couldn't make fit in these lights. There are flowers as well, and radiographs, dolls, bandages, especially in creations related to Nelson Rodriguez's work, the bandages to the granny have in itself the fragility as meaning and as sensation. And Rodriguez's dramatic tests refers much to the fragility of human relations, of hypocrisy as well. The machines to athleticism are also present on her designs all the time, and it impels bodies to a becoming condition. Instead of they are not there to help the character, but to extract from the character the human condition, the physics and intensities building bodies without organs. This is why this thinking in its whole instance is expressed by smithereens. The Onzo Edegani's work is thought like a collection of smithereens, because there are layers in each object, in each scene, in combination of signs, doing a truly combustion of deciphering forces. The manual impregnating the visual, and the vision that pluralizes actions, and the actions that runs to sensations. Through the game's trajectory, we can see clearly the force as domination, but also the object in which this domination force is exercised, as Deleuze noted in a class from 1976. He says also about his philosophy that we must work with a bag, and when we find something that suits, put in the bag. It is evident that there is a criterion for something to suit the difference, and if Deleuze collected materials to raise concepts, the Gunny by other side collects disdained objects on the streets and dumps, and raises an operative thinking on the stage, but also on galleries, museums, or in public space, wherever her work is residing. By doing this, and over the transmutation and the formation of these pieces, they remain something about their past and also about our lives to impregnating performances of the forces. If Deleuze...
2 minutes left.
Okay. If Deleuze uses this metaphorical bag to collect concepts and ideas, Zoë Edegani collects items, materials, that serve to her philosophy, that is, an operative one. In the scenic area, when from the transformation of this matter, the set designs will be filled with ideas, concepts, images of this spatial composition plan. To finalize, I would like to say that coupling of live and over is both the origin and the consequence of this work. For instance, her machines to athleticism grew from her experience as a motorcyclist, lived deeply. As a motorcyclist needs to be just one body with the motorcycle, performers are required in the same sense by saying objects in their set designs. Where bodies and objects must be inextricably related, more for its exercises than representation. Also, the fact that she had been an athlete more than 35 years ago also instrumented her to develop the survey about velocity variation, movement qualities, weight, and the others, as well as the relation between body and object. That are so frequent in her set design. This not predicted and common way of learning and developing this kind of relation gives a coupling also of living and creating that don't preserve anybody. If the creation is understood as the only way of breathing from a life that takes all lived experiences as material to resign on stage, meanings and consequences of being, becoming, and varying constantly and continuously. That is why she says she can teach how to be non-of. Because as an artist, she believes as is the life that makes you an artist when you do work from it. And what is life and thinking with no everlasting variation. Thank you so much for your attention.
Questions to the audience? Comments or
actually we talked before about maybe if you want to make questions for entry because we have like a half an hour.
I mean the student is supposed to finish at 6 but nevertheless, we can maybe extend a little bit more and do whatever.
So,
so of course, we are free to do that. Yes.
Maybe you can contextualize this artist in relation to other Brazilian artists.
Yes, I thank you for the question because I couldn't fit it here in these lines. A very peculiar characteristic that is make art in Brazil, I think. I don't know exactly here. I don't know much. Actually, we have an idea. But in Brazil, it is very difficult. We have no profits or money to serve the artistic creations. And that's why I think, of course, it is a reinvention of the skill of the profession. She uses to collect things on streets and these useless objects, but also for necessity. And what kind of contextualized are you talking about? I don't know if it's in this sense
I'm not familiar with Brazilian art, so is she exceptional or brilliant in this company?
Yes. This last, she is quite exceptional, I think. This last slide I showed, there was a note on public space. And there it is a very difficult to have it. I must say I arrived here and encountered a sculpture in each corner. And I thought, oh my God, here they have pieces of art on all the streets, but there it is very difficult to develop and to be recognizable for your work. That's why I think most of the artists used to work in institutions like universities, because it is very difficult to live from your artistic work. And she is an example of someone who really do this. Maybe sometimes taking things from her house to put on the stage because they don't have like how to provide it.
So I'm sorry, I'm extremely jet lagged, so I'm struggling to focus. But I didn't quite catch whether you said the artist was kind of inspired by the words or your interpretation.
No, the thing exactly what I observed is how her set designs don't use to decorate the stage or localize, but in the other sense, they require performance-wise to all these athleticism that we encounter on Deleuze's analysis of Francis Bacon's painting, for example. I could fit the theory and what I could realize in the practice in front of me. So, such a, like this kind of operation, parting flesh and bone, it is exactly the opposite. And despite the fact that it is on the theater, it is not there to help the character, but to extract from the character all the interpreting or representation, to bring the human condition that is common to all of us. Is it clear? I answered?
Please.
Yeah, I want to ask you about the relationship between the scenographer and the director. Because presumably she's working with a theater director at the same time as being an autonomous scenographer. So what is the...
Actually not. Many people say she would do direction, but she still stays on set design creations and customs. So, of course, there is an authorial set design, but it is related to all other elements. She does not sign the direction of the piece. Only the spatial arrangement, the visual signs, and basically it. Is it?
It's always a different director, or is it the same director she worked with?
She used to work with many directors. Sometimes it can repeat more than one, but she worked with many groups and companies. That's why she goes from galleries to theater, then performance, then dance, because that's why I think it's so plural. It don't fit in any field specifically, but just the opposite.
There are any more questions?
For the girls, maybe?
You don't. Okay, thank you so much.
Such a case. Again, supposed to be.